The headlines at this hour, 2 days after the gas leak in Delhi, the NGT issues a notice to state and central government. Residents now demand the removal of the container depot, but the chairman and managing director of Container Corporation of India terms the gas leak as a freak accident. The Aam Aadmi Party too busy to deal with the problems of the Aam Aadmi, while Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal battles corruption charges. Pending issues like water crisis, school fees hike and so much more goes unaddressed. A fatal accident and a shoddy investigation and a cover-up attempt. Investigations into the death of the actress Sonika Chauhan reveal the classic tale of deceit and betrayal. It is very possible that the person behind the wheel was drunk. Karnataka's MLAs continue to flaunt their VVIP status with arrogance. Traffic is halted and ambulance is forced to wait for the Karnataka Home Minister's convoy to pass. A BJP's Gorakhpur MLA flies off the handle. He humiliates and berates a woman IPS officer, all because she asked his men to break up their protest. Bizarre diktat for female students in Kerala. A female candidate appearing at an NEET examination in Kunur is allegedly asked to remove her innerwear before being allowed to enter the room to take her exam. Chant mantras and follow a strict diet for fairer, taller, more intelligent children. That's what Arogya Bharti Group claims. And that's not all. This RSS-run outfit also promises no labour pain and purification of the body in 90 days if you follow their outrageous formula. Despite objections from local citizens, the Bangalore Jai Mahal Road is all set to lose its green cover. 70 trees will be cut, 40 others will be transplanted. The citizens are up in arms. You're watching The Urban Debate on Mirror Now. I'm Faye D'Souza. Our story this evening is completely outrageous. Mantras and a strict diet could ensure you have fairer, taller children with higher IQ points. This is the claim being made at a recent Kolkata Garbh Sanskar workshop that claims that their program will enhance your child's genetics, that you will have a fair children. It goes on to, a fair child. It goes on to say that if you are dark parents, don't worry. We will tell you how to have fair children. We will tell you how to have taller children. We will tell you how to have smarter children if you are parents of not great IQ. I'm assuming that if people are falling for this, that they are assuming already that the ones who have come into this workshop are perhaps parents with not great IQ. Garbh Sanskar program. This program was recently conducted in Kolkata by a group called the Arogya Bharti Group, the official. It has sparked a debate among the doctors who say that these claims are completely false and baseless. Now, there are two problems here. One is promising parents who are short and perhaps of a darker complexion that they can, in fact, by chanting mantras, have taller, fairer babies. Secondly, what is the social implication of making a promise like this? This group and its promise is fundamentally racist. We need to call out the people who make promises like this that are obviously not backed by any science and that are leading people down the garden path to believe that you can, in fact, have fairer babies, making these parents effectively hate their own children when the entire thing doesn't work out. Take a look.
An official wing of the RSS group in Calcutta has been conducting seminars on Garbh Sanskar practice to help couples conceive genetically superior babies. The group allegedly claims that through Garbh Sanskar practice, these babies will be taller, smarter and fairer.
Hamare Rushi Muniyon ne, hamare scientists ne, 2,500 pehle jo prayog kiye hai, वो प्रयोग के जो नतीजे निकले हैं उनका कंक्लूजन या निष्कर्ष रूप से उन्होंने लिखा है
giving them false claims that, you know, the baby will be fair if you attend garbh sanskar, that is not scientific. Because the scientific truth is that there is a gene for fairness, there's a gene for the color of the skin, there's a gene for the height, there's a gene for, you know, a specific gene for all these physical attributes.
We don't definitely have no evidence to say that this can influence the color of the skin or how fair the child is or whether the child will be having a different genetic makeup. To claim that you can modify the sex of the child or the color of the skin of the child to have a fairer baby or things like that, that is certainly not true.
Well, here's the truth about it. Scientifically, doctors tell us that if you are of a certain color, as mother and father, it's very likely your children will be of that same color, whatever that color may be. If you are of a certain height, it's very likely that genetically your children will be of the same height, and they also inherit the intelligence that you have. Should this be allowed in a country that is already racist, that is already telling children who are dark-skinned that they're not good enough? Should we allow this sort of thing to continue, where parents are being told that if you follow these certain rules and do our workshops, that you will have taller, fairer, more intelligent babies, something that science completely refutes, something that common sense completely refutes, actually. And of course, what social impact does this have? If you're watching at home right now, which side of this debate do you fall on? You should pick up the phone and call us, because I'm quite concerned with the kind of trend that we're seeing come out of this Arogya Bharti group. Joining me on the show this evening, Nilanjana Chakraborty is a social activist in Kolkata. Naveen Chomal is an advocate. Vinod Bansal is the spokesperson of the Vishwa Hindu Parishad. Dr. Samir Dalwai is the president of the Mumbai branch of the Indian Academy of Pediatrics. We also have Vijay, an Ayurvedic physician who joins us in Nashik. He's also from the National Executive Council of the and a member of the Arogya Bharti organization. We have Dr. Kiran Coelho will join us through the course of this conversation. She's the head of gynecology at Leelavati Hospital. And Dr. Mandar Ranade is a gynecologist and a medical legal expert who joins us from Pune. I am going to start first with Vijay Kulkarni. Kulkarni ji, aap bataiye hame, how is it possible that the garbh samskar will actually, the workshop will allow people to have fairer, taller babies? Please explain to us.
Garbh samskar workshops are very much useful for creating awareness in the parents who are going to conceive. And after conception, Garbhini Paricharya is there. This program has three parts mainly. One before conception, that is Deha Shuddhi and Nadi Shuddhi is done. Deha Shuddhi is done by Ayurvedic Panchakarma, and Nadi Shuddhi is done with the help of yoga, pranayam, etc. So, firstly, Deha Shuddhi and Nadi Shuddhi is done before conception. After that, after conception, Garbhini Paricharya is a very important aspect, that is antenatal care. And Ayurvedic texts like Charak Samhita has very much importantly described.
Kulkarni ji, aap mujhe bataiye, iska effect kya hota hai bacche pe? What is the impact on the babies that are born?
Iska effect bacche pe healthy baby born hone mein hota hai, basically. Healthy baby means malnourished nahi hogi. Uska jo vajan hai, wo jitna apekshit hai, utna hoga. Uska skin jo hai, wo achha hoga. Uski buddhimatta jo hai, wo bhi achhi hogi. Ye sab baate usme, us healthy child mein create hogi. गर्भिणी परिचर्या संभालने से वो गर्भिणी माता जो माता होने वाली है उसका भी आरोग्य स्वास्थ्य ठीक रहता है और प्रसव के बाद आफ्टर डिलीवरी उसका जो स्तनपान है बच्चे का वो स्तनपान के लिए जो दूध आना चाहिए माता को
आप मुझे ये बताइए विजय कुलकर्णी जी देयर आर वेरियस प्रेस रिपोर्ट्स में ये बोला गया है कि गोरे बच्चे होंगे बच्चे लंबे होंगे बच्चे उनका आईक्यू अच्छा होगा कि अगर माँ बाप के यू नो स्किन कलर डार्क है तो गोरा बच्चा पैदा होगा, कि ये पॉसिबल है?
देखिए हाँ ये पॉसिबल है, क्योंकि आप गर्भिणी परिचर्या को अगर गौर से देखेंगे या पढ़ेंगे या समझ लेंगे तो आपको एक बात ध्यान में आएगी कि उसमें बेसिकली दो बातें उन्होंने कही है आयुर्वेदिक ऋषि मुनियों ने, जो हम लोग भी आयुर्वेदिक एज ए आयुर्वेदिक फिजिशियन लोगों को पेरेंट्स को कहते हैं अवेयरनेस के लिए। वो बात ऐसी है कि काउज मिल्क और काउज घी, ये दो बातों का उन्होंने बहुत बड़े पैमाने पर गौर किया है इस गर्भिणी परिचर्या में। इस 9 महीनों में जो प्रेग्नेंट वुमन रहती है उसमें उन्होंने वो कंज्यूम कर लेना चाहिए।
और उससे क्या होगा?
काउज मिल्क और काउज घी, उससे जो ग्लेयरनेस है स्किन का बढ़ता है, उससे बुद्धिमत्ता बढ़ती है। अभी ये तो प्रूव हो चुका है कि काउज मिल्क और काउज घी है उसमें ओमेगा 3 फैटी एसिड्स होते हैं और
इससे बच्चे गोरे होते हैं। आपका कहना है इससे बच्चे गोरे होते हैं? ठीक है ठीक है, लेट्स जस्ट लेट मी चेक विद द साइंटिस्ट ऑन दिस पैनल, डॉक्टर समीर दलवाई हु इज अ मेंबर ऑफ द ब्रांच ऑफ इंडियन एकेडमी ऑफ पीडियाट्रिक्स। डॉक्टर समीर, इज इट पॉसिबल दैट यू कैन हैव फेयर चिल्ड्रन इफ यू ड्रिंक काउज मिल्क व्हेन यू आर प्रेग्नेंट? इज दैट पॉसिबल?
Well, my first question is, why should somebody want to have fair children? How does it matter whether you have a fair child or not a fair child? And the answer is very simple. I'd just like to show this lovely book that I've been reading. And before somebody points out that it's written by some Western writer, let me say that the name here says Siddharth Mukherjee, who's very much an Indian doctor and a scientist and a writer. And I think it's very clear, and you mentioned it yourself, that of course, if you look at a pregnant lady, and if you look at giving her any kind of counseling and creating awareness about her nutrition, about her physical health, about her mental health, yes, it has an impact on the baby. And even if you increase the nutritional component of the mother or the pregnant lady's diet, you're definitely going to have a child with a much better nutrition. Even if you look at improving the anemia in the mother, it's going to improve the child.
Will this change height and skin color?
But it's ridiculous to even say that it's going to change skin color and the gender of the child and so on and so forth. There's absolutely no evidence for that.
Dr. Mandar Ranade, gynecologist and legal expert from Pune, how dangerous is it to promise expectant parents? Okay, we're going to get him on the show. I'll go back to Dr. Dalwai. How dangerous is it to promise expectant parents things like your children will be fairer?
Well, it's the danger is probably for the people promising it, because if you under some act of the Consumer Act or something, I'm sure if you're charging it, probably they'll take you to court. There's also an issue of the PCP and DT Act. There's a violation of trying to declare the gender and so on and so forth. So there are a lot of dangers, but I think the danger on the whole is to society at large. Why are we trying to say that you should have a fair baby? Why is it that you're trying to discriminate between a child who's fair and not fair? How does it matter? Are you trying to say that a child who's not fair is inferior in any way? And hence the matter is all about genetic modification or selection of
Let's
babies.
Let me go across to Vinod Bansal, spokesperson of the Vishwa Hindu Parishad, who joins us from Noida. Vinod Bansal,
hello.
What is the need to have fairer babies? What is the need to have taller babies, customized babies? There is also an Ayurvedic textbook that says that you can actually, if you use certain medicines, have boys instead of girls. Are we seriously, in this day and age, still making these promises? Where do you stand on these promises that are being made, Vinod Bansal?
देखिए फैजी, बात यह है कि एक तो सबसे पहले तो मुझे इस बात पर ऑब्जेक्शन है कि आपने जो डिबेट का स्टार्ट किया उसमें डिबेट में आपने प्री कंसीव्ड नोशन के साथ आपने शुरू किया कि मंत्रों के द्वारा कोई बच्चे को पैदा किया जा रहा है। दूसरी बात क्या है कि बच्चे गोरे पैदा होंगे, सिर्फ ये पॉइंट आपने लिया। तीसरी बात ये कि बच्चों को इन्होंने जो डॉक्टर साहब ने कहा वो ये कहा, ऐसा लग रहा है जैसे कि हम कोई ये जो आरोग्य भारती है कोई बच्चों को बेचने की कोई स्कीम निकाल रही है, कोई कस्टमर कोई कस्टमाइज कोई करके कोई मार्केट में प्रोडक्ट लॉन्च कर रहे हैं जो कि कंज्यूमर जो लॉ के हिसाब से ठीक नहीं है। दो बातें बड़ी इंपॉर्टेंट हैं फिर इसके, देखिए इसको बड़ा मतलब माइनॉरिटी लेना चाहिए। हमारे शास्त्रों में भी, ऋग्वेद में भी कहा गया है, मनुस्मृति में भी कहा गया है, हमारे 16 जन्म से लेकर के मृत्यु तक के 16 संस्कार हैं। उन 16 संस्कारों का एक एक का बड़ा विस्तार से वर्णन है। और ये जो गर्भाधान संस्कार है बड़ा प्योरली साइंटिफिक है। निश्चित रूप से एक ओवर ए पीरियड ऑफ टाइम जो है ना, ये चीज़ें जो है ना हमारे शास्त्रों से, हमारी जो स्टडी से धूमिल हो गई, इसके कारण गर्भ हुआ। लेकिन
मेरी
बात को पूरी होने दीजिए, मैं मेरी बात को पूरी होने दीजिए, मैं साइंस पर जा रहा हूँ। देखिए जैसे अभी डॉक्टर दलवाई ने कहा था, स्वयं कहा था इन्होंने कि भाई हाँ देखिए माल न्यूट्रिशन खत्म होगा अगर उनको प्रॉपर रेस्ट मिलेगा, प्रॉपर आपको न्यूट्रिएंट मिलेंगे और जो जो उनको डाइट के अलावा जो जरूरी चीज़ें हैं एक गर्भावस्था के टाइम पे वो अगर महिला को मिलेंगी तो निश्चित रूप से वो ठीक चीजें होंगी।
ठीक चीजें होंगे, ठीक चीजें होंगे मिस्टर विनोद बंसल, लेकिन गोरे बच्चे
जी,
गोरे बच्चे
नहीं नहीं देखिए
क्या ये कोई ठीक चीज है? गोरे बच्चे
आप गलत समझ रही हैं। देखिए मैं आपको फिर दोबारा बोल रहा हूँ, यू करेक्ट योर वर्जन। मैं कहना चाहता हूँ इसमें कोई गोरे बच्चे का कोई कमिटमेंट नहीं है। आरोग्य भारती
अभी 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 मिस्टर कुलकर्णी ने बोला कि इससे गोरे बच्चे पैदा होंगे। ये जो कलकत्ता में आपकी जो गर्भ विज्ञान जो केंद्र में आपकी आपकी जो वर्कशॉप हुई थी उसमें प्रॉमिस किया गया था कि गोरे बच्चे पैदा होंगे। दिस इज अ कांस्टेंट प्रॉमिस।
अरे उन्होंने ये और भी कहा था, कहीं और भी बातें कही उन्होंने गोरे बच्चे के अलावा, और भी बातें कही हैं कि संस्कारवान बच्चे होने चाहिए, राष्ट्रप्रेमी बच्चे होने चाहिए, बच्चे टॉलर और शॉर्टर जो चाहे वैसे वैसे कर सकता है। इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि प्रोडक्ट मार्केट में बिच रहा है। क्वेश्चन ये है कि
कैन यू मेक योर चाइल्ड टॉलर बाय ईटिंग और ड्रिंकिंग एनीथिंग ड्यूरिंग द प्रेगनेंसी?
No, it's not about being a child taller. It's about, I mean, are you saying, trying to say that a fairer child is more nationalistic and a darker child is not nationalistic? What are you trying to say?
Not at all. Kisne kaha is baat ke liye?
Aapne kaha.
Fairer or darker ka koi nationalism matlab hi nahi hai.
Stick to scientific facts what they are saying.
मतलब
कोई गोरे से नहीं होता।
अरे आपने खुद कहा कि गोरा बच्चा हो सकता है, तो ये बताइए कैसे हो सकता
है? हो सकता है, मैं कहता हूँ काला भी हो सकता है। भाई कास्ट आपको क्या लग रहा है कि जो जो बच्चे गोरे नहीं होते क्या अच्छे नहीं होते? हमने नहीं कहा ये, तो आप मिस इंटरप्रेट कर
रहे
हैं। मैं ये कह रहा हूँ आपको, देखिए साइंस इस बात को प्रूव कर चुकी है।
होता है आप ये हम कह रहे हैं और आयुर्वेद जो कहता है ना, आप दो बातों पे थोड़ी गलत फहमी हो रही है। कोई भी प्रॉमिस नहीं कर रहा है, ये खाली अवेयरनेस ऑफ द सोसाइटी है। पहली बात ये आपने समझ लेना चाहिए। ये कोई जैसे बंसल जी ने बताया कि कोई प्रोडक्ट लेके आरोग्य भारती नहीं जा रही है।
नहीं।
हमारे हमारे शास्त्रों ने, मैडम प्लीज एक दो मिनट में मैं बताता हूँ, हमारे
हाँ,
शास्त्रों ने जो लिखा है निष्कर्ष रूप से लिखा है। देखिए, इदम आगम सिद्धत्वात् प्रत्यक्ष फल दर्शनात् मंत्रवत् संप्रयोक्तव्यम् न मीमांसा कदाचन, ये हमारे शास्त्राचार्य लिखते हैं। और दे वेर ऑल्सो उन्होंने 2,500 पहले प्रयोग करके जो कंक्लूजन है वो कंक्लूजन रूप से ये ग्रंथों की रचना की है। जैसे आज डेविडसन का मेडिसिन पढ़ते हैं, पेडियाट्रिक्स पढ़ते हैं, पैथोलॉजी पढ़ते हैं, ये सब रचना जैसी साइंटिफिक है वैसी ही ये साइंटिफिक रचना है और प्रयोगों के ऊपर आधारित है। उन्होंने जो प्रयोग किए उसका निष्कर्ष ये है कि अच्छा बच्चा चाहिए, हेल्दी बच्चा चाहिए। और हेल्दी का मतलब गोरा बच्चा ऐसे नहीं है, स्किन उसका अच्छा चाहिए, स्किन का ग्लेयर अच्छा चाहिए। मैंने पहले ही बताया कि गोरा बच्चा, ये आप गलत फहमी। और जेंडर की बात आप निकालिए नहीं, आपने पूछा है कि पूसवन का आप जिक्र कर रहे हैं शायद, तो पूसवन का कोई समर्थन अभी आयुर्वेदिक फ्रेटर्निटी नहीं करती है। और आपको बताता हूँ, पूसवन जैसा स्त्री सवन भी बताया है आयुर्वेद टेक्स्ट ने। सिर्फ पूसवन नहीं, बदनाम आयुर्वेद के लोग कर रहे हैं कि पूसवन करके जेंडर का इम्बैलेंस कर रहे लोग, ये बात सही नहीं है। स्त्री सवन भी बताया और इसका सेंटर पॉइंट सुप्रजा है, आप ये ध्यान में रखिए। सुप्रजा गर्भ संस्कार ये इसका सेंटर पॉइंट है, होना चाहिए। और अवेयरनेस क्रिएट करने के लिए हम लोग जा रहे हैं और जाना चाहते हैं और जाएंगे भी। और ये थोड़ा एग्रेसिव करेंगे तो लोग तुरंत आ जाए, आयुर्वेद में ये किया है वो किया है। अरे जो आप अभी मॉडर्न मेडिसिन में जो कर रहे हैं, जो गलत बातें चल रही है उसके ऊपर नहीं लोग ध्यान देते ज्यादा।
नीलांजना चक्रवर्ती, व्हाट इज द सोशल डेंजर of this sort of thing?
Oh my God, the social danger is so much. You know, when they were talking, when they're conversing, I'm just reminded of World War II, during when the Nazi rule, they wanted to create genetically modified community. So they killed these number of Jews and Hebrews, etc. So Hitler wanted to do that. So are we going into that era? are we going?
What analogy are you drawing, madam? Is somebody talking about killing over here? What are you saying, madam? Please talk something sensible.
Let her finish talking. Let her finish talking. You can respond after that. Let her finish talking. No, no. Let her finish talking. You cannot decide whether or not. No, no. Naveen Chomal. Naveen Chomal, let her finish. Naveen Chomal, you are of the habit of interrupting women when they're talking. Let her finish her point and then I will give you a chance to respond. You didn't interrupt any of the men. Let her finish talking. Naveen Chomal. Naveen Chomal, let her finish talking.
You have to hear the other person's point of view as well.
Let her finish talking. Please, Nilanjana Chakraborty, finish speaking.
So what is happening is, what is even more scary is that, you know, procreation is a very, very private matter. Here they're bringing it out completely into the open. It's like a mass baby syndrome.
Not
mass
at all.
Baby
no,
production that's happening. No, please keep quiet. I'm not talking to you. I'm answering the question.
Talk something sensible, madam.
आप यही impression दे रहे हैं. आप यही impression दे रहे हैं. इसको आप correct करिए. अगर आप चाहते हैं कि मास स्वस्थ रहे, correct diet हो, nutrition हो, तो आपके उसमें क्यों लिखा हुआ है कि बच्चा जो है has to be tall, fair, even if it's a dark.
So what
Why
is wrong
are you
in
making it so
baby?
Complexion oriented?
It's a good part of our personality.
What do you mean a short baby is not good?
No.
No, but why should you then? What is the problem? No, but the problem is in our country we are so
If somebody doesn't have a tall baby, are you opposed? If somebody has a smaller baby, are you against him? Are you trying to say that it's a bad thing to happen? That is what exactly you are trying to say all this while. I said very clearly at the beginning, there is enough evidence to show that if you have good nutrition and
the best,
so good height is also part of a personality.
You may call it your personality. That's not necessary. So those who are short have bad personality. That's your perception.
No.
Those who have short personality have poor personality. That's your perception. And you're trying to create a race of tall, beautiful, handsome, fair children.
Yes, that's nothing wrong in that.
No, so say that's
somebody is very good. Somebody is good, tall.
So somebody is short and dark is not good. Is that what you're saying? Yes, that's what you're saying. And that's why people said that we've tolerated those who are dark skinned from the south of India. Sometime back somebody said this.
Something. I think you're having some agenda against.
I have no agenda against anybody. I didn't use the word RSS anywhere. You talked about a good personality being a tall person. I object to that. You said you about a tall person having a good personality. I object to that.
See, Dr. Dalwai, since you have hatred against some people...
I've hatred against your prejudice. I've hatred against saying somebody is tall, he's good, and if he's short, he's not good. Somebody is fair, he's good, he's dark, he's not good. I have hatred against this.
It is not lying.
One second.
In fact, history is the best evidence. Even our Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj was not tall.
You just said that means he has bad personality. That means he has bad personality.
Naveen Chomal.
Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj slayed Afzal Khan.
One second. This particular workshop that we're talking about, according to reports in the media, is what is needed, from what we understand, for a woman to deliver an uttam santati.
Yes.
A customized perfect child.
It is not customized.
So tell me what is a perfect child.
Yes, yes.
Describe to me what is a perfect child.
Let me. Is a tall, fair baby a perfect child? Yes.
A tall, fair baby is a perfect child.
Let me deal with this issue in details. Chakraborty madam, please give me a chance to speak now. See, in 1985 itself, in 1985 itself, the BBC had declared very proudly that in England, they have started courses for the pregnant woman so that the children in the womb, they are given what we call as garbha sanskar. They had used their own words, but they are given proper training. So when they are born healthy, tall, more intelligent, more receptive. And we are looking to Jews from Israel with Eve, because their women, when they are pregnant, they are solving all mathematics puzzle. They are eating a lot of cauliflower oil and all those walnuts and they are having all those things, intellectual things, which makes the Jews very brilliant people in the world. So we respect them.
One second.
But the very same thing which is in our science for thousands of years. So there is a sect
Naveen
of
Chomal,
people
Naveen
in our
Chomal,
country
respond
who are jealous
to
of the Hindu superiority. They are using all sorts of different words to
Naveen Chomal. Okay, I'm quoting here. One second. I'm reading from and we have spoken to each of these people and we have verified these quotes. Dr. Hitesh Jani is the national convener of Arogya Bharti. He has given this official response. Parents may have lower IQ, with a poor educational background, but their babies can have higher IQ.
Yes.
If proper procedures followed, parents of dark-skinned babies of dark-skinned parents with lesser height can be born with fair complexion and taller height.
There you go.
Of course.
What is wrong in trying to have our next generation more healthy, more intelligent,
fairer.
More smarter? Yes,
fairer.
Fairness is also a virtue of a good society.
I beg your pardon, Mr. Naveen Chomal. Fairness is racism.
Nothing of that. Nothing of that.
Our skin color comes from our parents and we should be proud of our skin color. How does each of us get a skin color directly from our parents?
Definitely.
And we should be proud. And if you tell people that dark-skinned babies are unwanted and undesired,
are we saying this? Are we saying this? No,
white-skinned babies are better babies.
When you say babies of dark skin, we respect foreigners for having good personality.
No, we don't. You might, but I do not.
Very proudly said that in England they are doing all those experiments. How intelligent.
What
see, the problem with the educated and the particular MBBS doctors in our country is that everything what Westerners say is science according to them. But what Ayurveda says, according to them, they start condemning it.
Listen. Okay? I am simply arguing one point.
Yes?
You cannot and you should not in our country have any sort of workshop that tells parents that their children are better if they are fairer. Let me just bring in Dr. Kiran Coelho. Dr. Kiran Coelho joins us on the show right now. Dr. Kiran Coelho is a gynecologist and a medical legal expert. Dr. Coelho, is it you've seen these claims, obviously. Do you agree that you can modify your child's height and skin color by chanting mantras or by consuming cow's milk?
Well, certainly not. There's no scientific truth in it at all. The color of the skin is because of a gene. It is a genetic because of the parent's color and has nothing to do with whatever the person eats or drinks or consumes. However, I must say that garbha sanskar, or the education of the baby in the womb, is a wonderful thing because in many cultures, the Koreans, the Japanese, all follow it. And if the mother is in a soothing atmosphere, if she is, follows the garbha sanskar type of method where she bonds with the baby before and plays, is relaxed, is given advice on diet, exercise, etc., it's a good thing. But to tell a person that because if you do garbha sanskar, you will have a fair child, that is not scientific.
See, the fairness is not the only thing that they are assuring to the parents. What they are basically aiming is to have a very healthy child with a good personality and good IQ.
That includes being fair, Naveen Chomal.
So fairness is one of the aspects of it. And I would definitely say with confidence that there is nothing wrong in being fair. It's one of the virtues of the personality. All over the world, since thousands of years, even the Roman literature had one of the famous sentences, why should I die if the woman is fair? So for thousands of years, all over the world across, the people have been liking people with the fair complexion.
Naveen Chomal, there's a word for that. It's called racism.
Naveen Chomal, it is racism.
That is fundamentally the definition of racism. And this sort of narrow-minded thinking is what is wrong with our country today.
It's more than better than me. I should respect them. They are taller than me.
So you respect Akshay Kumar just because he is fairer than you.
This sort of narrow-minded thinking is what is wrong with our country. I should not get jealous of those people. I should respect him. He's got a good personality. Which is wrong with you, Naveen Chomal?
Absolutely nothing wrong. What is wrong is with the left-minded journalist. That is only thing trying to malign the Hindu culture from the something.
You are racist. And let me point out to you. Let me one second.
All the doctors.
Let me go. Let me go. Let me go to Vinod Bansal. Let me go to Vinod Bansal. Vinod Bansal. Actually assuming that fairer people are better than darker people, is that in any way representative of the Hindu culture? Is that what we believe as Indians?
देखिए मैं उम्मीद करूंगा जैसे मैं लोगों को सुन रहा था वैसे मुझे भी सुनेंगे आप. पहले इनको बोलने दीजिए.
विनोद जी एक देखिए, फेयरनेस और टॉलरनेस पे आप लोग अटके हुए हैं. देखिए आज मदर मॉर्टेलिटी रेट देखिए हमारे नेशन का, चाइल्ड मॉर्टेलिटी रेट देखिए हमारे नेशन का, हमारे माल नरिश्ड जो चिल्ड्रन है, माल न्यूट्रिशन का जो प्रॉब्लम है वो देखिए, और ये देखकर फिर स्वस्थ राष्ट्र का जो निर्माण है वो स्वस्थ व्यक्ति, स्वस्थ परिवार, स्वस्थ ग्राम और स्वस्थ राष्ट्र, ये चार सूत्रों पर आरोग्य भारती चलती है. और स्वस्थ राष्ट्र के निर्माण के लिए एक छोटा माध्यम यह है कि बेटर चाइल्ड, मतलब स्वस्थ चाइल्ड की निर्मिति.
बिल्कुल
बिल्कुल सर, ये तो हम फुल्ली मानते हैं विजय कुलकर्णी जी, ये हम मानते
हैं.
इट्स वेरी क्लियर दैट इफ यू वांट टू हैव अ वेल नरिश्ड बेबी, बट लेट मी
मेंशन, मेरा नंबर नहीं आया है जी.
देयर इज नो जेलसी.
मेरा नंबर नहीं आया.
व्हाई आर यू ब्रिंगिंग रिलीजन इनटू इट?
एज अ सुपीरियर टू
व्हाई आर यू ब्रिंगिंग रिलीजन इनटू इट? इट्स वेरी क्लियर दैट इफ यू गिव गुड न्यूट्रिशन टू अ गर्ल और टू अ यंग वुमन इवन बिफोर शी gets pregnant, it has been proved in all studies and it is not part of any religion or any pathy that if you give good nutrition to a young girl even before she gets pregnant and especially when she gets pregnant, and if you give her good mental and physical health during a pregnancy, it is known by science that the child will be healthy born. Now are you opposing it because it is some other thing? No, so why are you bringing religion into it? They are not talking about religion. This is known science. The point that you are opposing here.
Let me bring in Dr. Mandar. Dr. Mandar Ranade joins us right now from Pune. Dr. Ranade, you've been hearing. We'll come to you. Dr. Ranade, is there any scientific proof at all? And I'm only going after scientific proof here. Is there a scientific proof that if you eat something or drink something or chant a certain mantra, your child will be fairer and taller than you are as parents?
गलत बता रही हैं आप खुद ही गलत बता रही हैं.
Sir, आपके representatives ने ये response दिया.
Please
listen to Dr. Mandar Ranade. It's a very straightforward question. Dr. Ranade, please go ahead.
No, if you are posing a wrong question, false question, you are going to elicit a false answer only.
Naveen Chomal, let me
answer. The answer to wrong milegi milega.
Exactly.
इसके बाद आप लोग दूसरा question पूछ लीजिए, उनको जवाब देने दीजिए. Doctor Ranade, please go ahead.
Discussion which is going on, and there are two parts of your question. Whether what Arogya Bharti is doing is scientific, or what is told in the Arogya Bharti is scientific. Now, to be very practical, in Ayurveda, in Charak Samhita and Sushruta Samhita, in the manuscripts which is written 5000 years before Christ, all these things like Garbha Samskar, that Garbha Varna and Netra Varna, all these things are mentioned elaborately. Now, if somebody does research in foreign countries and then that brings that thing to you to India, then we call it as scientific. Now, things are written over here in Charak Samhita, Sushruta Samhita. We are supposed to explore these things. But mind you, this is an era of evidence-based medicine. So if somebody claims like they are changing the height or they are changing the color, then there must be some evidence of say 500 patients, 1000 patients with the probability, scientific test applied and all. If somebody is claiming those things without any evidence, then Magic Remedies Act applies and these all claims and assurances are absolutely illegal. Now, I through this discussion, I appeal that these all things which are written in the manuscripts which say about the diet, about the mantra and all those things should be seen from different angle, not from making your child taller or shorter like that. But we can eradicate some diseases which are chromosome linked, which are genetic linked, and if some proper research with Prakruti and genome can be done, then these particular regimens of the diet or some useful medicines can be utilized to eradicate or eliminate some chromosome linked or gene linked diet, gene linked diseases or not. So this is a new issue which I am putting in front of the panel, apart from politicizing or socializing the issue.
One second.
Definitely, I agree with Dr. Ranade.
So what you said is absolutely right, and this is what we are saying, that this is a time of evidence-linked medicine. Somebody said that only medicine from abroad is brought here. That's wrong. There is a huge amount of research. Huge amount of research going on in India, and you're insulting all those people who are doing research in India. When you mention about genetics and chromosome, again, it's very important. I'm not denying it or I'm not opposing you. Let's have some trials. Let's have some research on it. And let's then verify whether it's happening. That's all one is saying.
So that should be done here.
Dr. Ramesh Gautam is the head of Arogya Bharti in Nagpur. Joins us on the phone line right now. Dr. Gautam, thank you for joining us. Dr. Gautam, please tell us, from the reports that we're seeing, there are office bearers of Arogya Bharti who have said that... Do we have Dr. Gautam on the phone line? Dr. Gautam, can you hear me?
I'm here. Yes, doctor.
I just want to understand, from the reports that we have received so far and the phone calls that my team has made to various office bearers of Arogya Bharti, the promises are of children of higher IQ, taller children, children with fairer complexion, no labor pain during the actual delivery, and repairs of genes ensuring the genetic defects are not passed on to babies. Are these promises that you stand by at Arogya Bharti?
No, not at all. Arogya Bharti ka jo lakshya hai, woh koi matlab gore logon ko taiyar karna ya jo kaale hain unke bare mein nakaratmak soch banana ya koi jo baat hai unke bare mein aisa bilkul nahi hai. Is bare mein Arogya Bharti kaam nahi karti. हमारे शास्त्रों में भगवान कृष्ण जो काले हैं और वो पुरुषोत्तम माने जाते हैं. हमारे शास्त्र में, भारतीय शास्त्र में वामन देवता जो थे वो डार्क व्यक्ति थे, लेकिन वो हमारे दशावतार के एक बने हुए हैं. इस कारण से टॉलर फेयर ये जो विषय हैं, ये तो बिल्कुल ही छोटे विषय. हम तो श्रेष्ठ संतति निर्माण हो, नई पीढ़ी एक श्रेष्ठ गुणों से युक्त हो, उनका इमोशनल, उनका स्पिरिचुअल, उनका ये सारी बातें अच्छी हो, इस भूमिका को लेकर काम कर रहे हैं. ये जो बातें हैं, ये वास्तव में जो भी कुछ मुझे नहीं मालूम कोलकाता में वहाँ के संबंधियों ने क्या बात करी, लेकिन ये तो सारा डिस्टॉर्टेड करके आरोग्य भारती केवल गोरे लोगों के लिए ऊंचे लोगों के कर रही है, और ये बाकी जो बात है सारी जो मीडिया में चल रही है, एक प्रकार से आरोग्य भारती को बदनाम करने का
जी. आप बताइए, डॉक्टर हितेश जानी आरोग्य भारती के नेशनल कन्वीनर है.
जी जी, नहीं नॉट ए नेशनल कन्वीनर ऑफ आरोग्य भारती, ही इज जस्ट ए मेंबर ऑफ द आरोग्य भारती, एंड ही इज वर्किंग देयर एज ए इन ही हैज व्हाट हिज ओन इंस्टीट्यूशन देयर. ओके,
लेकिन उनका डॉक्टर हितेश जानी के जितने सारे कमेंट्स हैं वो आपके वेबसाइट पे मेंशन है, और उनके कमेंट्स में पढ़ रही हूँ अभी. उनका कहना है कि पेरेंट्स हैव अ लोअर आईक्यू, देयर बेबी कैन बी एक्सट्रीमली राइट इफ प्रॉपर प्रोसीजर. नवीन चौहान, इफ प्रॉपर प्रोसीजर इज फॉलोड, बेबीज ऑफ डार्क स्किन्ड पेरेंट्स विद लेसर हाइट कैन हैव फेयर कम्प्लेक्शन एंड ग्रो टॉलर. ये डॉक्टर हितेश जानी का कहना है, और ये आपके हितेश जानी जी आपके वेबसाइट पे भी लिस्टेड है.
मेरी बात तो ये हितेश जानी और डॉक्टर करिश्मा नरवानी जी हैं, इनका अनुसंधान केंद्र करके जामनगर गुजरात में है. उनका वो अलग से काम चलता है, उस बारे में उनकी अपनी अलग की सोच है. मैं आपको एक बार और बता दूं, ये टाइम्स म्यूजिक जो है, जो आपका ही चैनल है, आपका ही
आप ये बताइए, एक मिनट. सो यू आर सेइंग दैट देयर आर डिफरेंट ग्रुप्स राइट नाउ इन डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री हु आर रनिंग डिफरेंट प्रोग्राम्स, and each program has a different system that is run. Is that what you're saying?
Right. नहीं मुझे कहना है कि देखिए एक मैं आपको इसके एक बात बोल के मैं अपनी बात आगे करता हूँ। टाइम्स न्यूज़ ने गर्भ संस्कार पर सीडी बनाई है।
हाँ हाँ सर, मुझे बस सी आई लेट मी मेक दिस वेरी क्लियर, लेट मी मेक दिस वेरी क्लियर, आई एम नॉट क्वेश्चनिंग आयुर्वेदा, I am not questioning whether or not women in our country should be given good food in order to have healthy babies. I am not questioning that. I have only one pain point. If there is someone who remotely suggested that you can have fair babies, you have done a massive disservice to everybody in this country, especially the women. Yogita, I sorry, Nilanjana Chakraborty, go ahead.
मैं इसका जवाब दूं क्या आप?
हाँ हाँ, मैं आती हूँ आपके, निरंजना चक्रवर्ती को बोल दीजिए, उसके बाद आप जवाब
निकल चुका जाते हो।
बंसल, निरंजना चक्रवर्ती, गो अहेड।
आई जस्ट वांट टू ऐड समथिंग फेयर।
यस,
आई जस्ट वांट टू ऐड समथिंग। यू नो, वी एज यू राइटली सेड, वी बिलीव इन द आयुर्वेदा, आई ऑल्सो बिलीव इन मनुस्मृति, वैदिक साइंसेज, बिकॉज दे आर पार्ट ऑफ आर हिस्ट्री एंड कल्चर, बट द वे इट हैज बीन डिस्टॉर्टेड एंड द वे इट हैज बीन प्रोजेक्टेड, दैट्स वेयर द ऑब्जेक्शन इज। And when you are reading out from the manifesto, you see it's very, very easy to distort it, because we are a country which has illiterate people. They do not understand. They will pick up all the wrong things. So the projection and the representation is very bad. The fact of the matter remains that जो sciences है, जो हमारे पुराने उसमें कहा गया है, उसमें तो कोई dispute नहीं है, वो है सो है, but आप लोग जिस तरह से इसको पेश कर रहे हैं वहां पे objection है, और आप ये नहीं समझ रहे कि इसका सामाजिक एक बहुत बुरा असर पड़ने वाला है। और हमारे देश में जहां पे हम ये कितने ये फीमेल इन्फेंटिसाइड वगैरह 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 इतने सारे और ईल्स हैं जिससे लड़ रहे हैं, इसको पॉजिटिव रूप से ना देख के इसको बहुत नेगेटिव अंडरटोन्स में लिया जाएगा। मैं नहीं कह रही हूँ कि आप लोग जो कह रहे हैं संपूर्ण गलत है, वो आयुर्वेदा में है, बट आप लोग ये क्यों नहीं कह रहे हैं कि औरत को, एक गर्भवती महिला को अच्छी तरह से अगर उनको न्यूट्रिशन दिया जाए, हेल्थ हाइजीन टेक केयर, आप इसको प्रोपगेट करिए। आप उसके अंदर ये क्यों,
उसी की तो बात हो रही है,
बच्चा टॉल होगा,
आईक्यू अच्छा होगा, आप पता नहीं कहाँ पहुँच गए,
काला होगा, आप ये क्यों बोल रहे हैं,
गलत फहमी से उसको ले रहे हैं
आप, ये गलत आप लोग
विजय कुलकर्णी जी, we are saying that if there's anybody in this country promising parents fairer babies, you are doing something wrong. So my limited point to you, Mr. Kulkarni, is that if there is somebody in your system, in some part of the country, making this promise, you must crack down on that person immediately, and you must communicate to these parents that this promise is completely impractical and it will never happen. You will never have babies that are fairer than you. ये आपको बोलनी चाहिए. मिस्टर डॉक्टर कुलकर्णी,
ये आप एक मिनट मुझे बोलने दीजिए. एविडेंस बेस की बात चल रही है, वो एक पॉइंट मैं आपको बताता हूँ. जो एविडेंस बेस है, आज जो रिसर्च होता है वही साइंटिफिक है क्या, मैं पूछना चाहता हूँ. जो 3000 साल पहले हुआ है और उसका कंक्लूजन के रूप में जो ग्रंथ लिखे हुए हैं हमारे ऋषि मुनियों ने, आचार्यों ने, तो आयुर्वेदाचार्यों ने, योगाचार्यों ने, वो गलत है क्या? वो अनसाइंटिफिक है क्या?
Nobody is saying what you are saying is wrong. We respect what you are saying. Our only objection is, do not bring color and these attributes into it. That's all.
Yes.
There is so much of dearth for people to work in the field of child health that all of us need to work together. So let's stick to those things which are non-controversial. Let's talk about nutrition. Let's talk about decreasing low birth weight. Let's talk about decreasing
Vijay Kulkarni.
Let's talk about decreasing maternal mortality, decreasing neonatal infant mortality by whatever way, as long as it helps everybody. We only want to request you. I'm saying we only want to request you. Please keep these aspects out of it. Let's not mix religion with it. Let's not mix color with it.
No, we don't.
I didn't.
No.
So we're just saying let's focus on the good
things. I will take it a step further. Even if you can scientifically prove, Mr. Kulkarni, that you can create fairer babies, I will thank you to keep that proof to yourself. Because if you start saying that parents can have fairer babies, you are actually creating a hatred for dark skin in this country.
No,
which I think is extremely unfair. Dr. Ravi Mehta is on the phone line.
Where are you from baby? You are also talking about other things. Look at that.
Please, we request that you leave those good things. 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 Le उसी को करिए, सब एक साथ मिलके
काम
If the good points are there, they are needed. Now, remove the one bad point. Now, fair, you are very radiant example. Fair, you are radiant example. Dr. Ravi Mehta is on the phone line from Mumbai. Dr. Mehta, go ahead. Yes, I have been listening to the debate, and there are a few points that I just want to put up. Number one, I believe that no doubt it should not be stated that these ancient sciences of India are bad, or we are trying to portray it in a bad light. But at the same time, it should be realized that we need, in this today's world of evidence-based medicine, we need the evidence, and that is how it should be. I would say it should be a joint alliance between the two sciences. We should come up with a, let's say, a randomized controlled trial on this.
But Dr. Mehta, do you? And my point here, Dr. Mehta, I understand what you're saying. Do you believe, first of all, that it is, and my point, it's, and I'm making this over and over again, I'm going to tell you, my only pain point in this entire thing is fairer babies. I think we have a huge issue in this country as far as skin color is concerned. Women suffer terribly. I think that you should make it a point, all organized people to remove this promise. No, I want only to debate this one point. Only one point. That is what I'm having a debate about.
No, why are you trying to malign the entire institution?
Maligning the institution.
The question of your debate was something different. Now you're changing the goalpost, madam.
I'm saying the one thing. How can you promise fairer, taller babies? How can you promise fairer, taller babies? It is impossible.
I'll give you a radiant example.
Medically impossible. It is scientifically impossible.
I'll give you a radiant example.
And even if you can, you are doing a massive disservice to our country by telling parents that fairer, taller babies are better in some way. In our country, where we are of every different shade.
No. I'll give you a radiant example, madam.
आप बोलने का मौका नहीं देती किसी को और आप अपनी अपनी बात को जबरदस्ती इसको किसी दूसरे के मुंह में क्यों डालना चाहती हैं? आप बार-बार अगर उत्तम संतति की बात आई है तो उत्तम संतति की बात करिए ना. फॉर फेयर एंड टॉलर के पीछे क्यों पड़ी हुई हैं आप? आप सीधा सीधा क्यों नहीं कहती क्या मीनिंग है आपका फेयर एंड टॉलर का? जब वो बार बार कह रहे हैं कि फेयर एंड टॉलर का मतलब है उत्तम संतति का मतलब ये नहीं है कि सिर्फ मंत्र के माध्यम से, सिर्फ घी के माध्यम से या सिर्फ दूध के माध्यम से संतति पैदा होगी. संतति पैदा होगी योग, ध्यान, प्राणायाम, उत्तम आहार, उत्तम विहार, उत्तम विचार और उत्तम प्रकृति और उत्तम आपका रहना खाना और उसका उत्तम वातावरण होना चाहिए, तब उसके बाद में उत्तम संतति पैदा होगी. अब मैं 40 मिनट से आपका इंतजार कर रहा हूँ कि शायद आप टाइम देंगी मुझे, लेकिन लेकिन बड़ा पार्शियल डिबेट आप करती हैं फेजी, मुझे बड़ा दुख हो रहा है. लेकिन मैं मुझे बताइए आपको, क्या उत्तम संतति का मतलब सिर्फ टॉलर बेबी होता है क्या? क्या उत्तम संतति का मतलब सिर्फ फेयर बेबी भी होता है क्या? और क्या गोरे बच्चे अच्छे नहीं होते क्या, या काले बच्चे अच्छे नहीं होते, या छोटे बच्चे अच्छे नहीं होते? और दूसरी बात मुझे बताइए, आपने कहा कि मंत्र के माध्यम से सिर्फ बच्चे पैदा करेंगे हम, या सिर्फ जो है ना वो आपके घी और दूध पिलाने से होंगे? कैसी बात कर रहे हो आप? आप हिंदू संस्कृति और धर्मशास्त्र को चैलेंज कर रहे हो आप टीवी चैनल पर बैठ के? आप पढ़ते नहीं है, देखिए ये पूरी संस्कार विधि है और इस संस्कार विधि को देखिए और पूरे वेदों के अंदर लिखा हुआ है साफ साफ कि कैसे उत्तम संतति पैदा करें, और आप टॉलर और फेयर के पीछे पड़े हुए हैं. अरे भाई प्रकृति देखिए, आदमी की देखिए, जब तक सही समय पर गर्भाधान नहीं होगा, गर्भाधान की पूरी देखभाल नहीं होगी, अच्छा आहार विहार आचार विचार नहीं होगा, अच्छे उनकी देखभाल नहीं होगी, अगर माँ बाप अब स्वस्थ नहीं होंगे तो बच्चे स्वस्थ कैसे रहेंगे? मुझे बताइए, आखिरकार ये सब चीजें आपको समझनी पड़ेगी. और सिर्फ और डिबेट को एक तरफा ले जा करके आप मिसकंसेप्शन मत फैलाइए.
बंसल साहब दुनिया के अंदर बिल्कुल सही कह रहे हैं.
लेट मी जस्ट क्लैरिफाई माय पॉइंट. विजय बंसल मुझे एक क्लैरिफिकेशन देने दीजिए आप मुझे. आई एम 100% अग्रीमेंट विद यू विजय बंसल. 100% नवीन चोमाल, वेट काम डाउन, एवरीबॉडी काम डाउन, लेट मी स्पीक विद विजय बंसल. आई एम इन 100% अग्रीमेंट विद एवरीथिंग दैट मिस्टर विनोद बंसल हैज जस्ट सेड. If you give, like the doctors on this panel have agreed, Mr. Bansal, if you give a mother and her to be child a safe, secure environment where they are being challenged intellectually, they are being fed well, they are given peace and calm, and they are given a good environment, then you will obviously have a healthy baby. I'm in full agreement, and there is no country more in need of this than the country of India. My only point, sir, is that this particular, if there is anybody in this country who is offering this service, they need to make sure that they remove claim that is not true.
आप फिर गलत बोल रही हैं, फिर आप गलत बोल रही हैं. कोई ऑफर नहीं कर रहा सर्विसेज को, कोई ये आरोग्य भारती कोई सर्विसेज बेचने के लिए नहीं है. This is just to have a mass awareness. देखिए धर्म शास्त्रों का आंसर क्या कहा है, आयुर्वेद क्या कहता है, योग क्या कहता है, और बाकी चरक संहिता क्या कहती है, इन सब चीजों को जनता तक पहुंचाने के लिए आरोग्य भारती ने एक प्रयास किया है. मुझे लगता है आपको उसकी सराहना करनी चाहिए. आप उसकी खाल उतारने लगे पड़े हैं, कमाल की बात है. आप टीवी चैनल पे बैठ के आपने पढ़ा होता ना कम से कम ये संस्कार विधि. स्वामी दयानंद सरस्वती ने
डॉक्टर
क्या लिखती है. मैं देखिए 40 मिनट से आपकी डिबेट का इंतजार कर रहा था, चुपचाप सुन रहा था, सभी लोगों को धैर्य के साथ सुन रहा था, लेकिन आपने मौका नहीं दिया, इसलिए मैं बताना चाहता हूँ. आप डिबेट को स्वयं हाईजैक करने की कोशिश कर रही हैं.
मिस्टर बंसल, आप पिछले 5 मिनट से बोले जा रहे हैं, मैंने आपको मौका दिया जवाब दिया. आप इतने अपसेट मत होइए, इट्स अ साइंटिफिक डिस्कशन.
आप डिबेट में ये बताइए कि आखिरकार आरोग्य भारती का मकसद क्या है.
This debate is not about whether garbh sanskar is good or not. Is that quite clear?
Yes.
It is that whether they should propagate that with this garbh sanskar, the child will be fair or not.
Yes.
And I agree there is no scientific basis to that. In fact, every single, you know, this fairness issue, you won't believe that when we give iron supplements to patients, they don't have it because someone has told them that the baby will become dark if they take iron supplements. So it's so ingrained in every Indian woman that she should have a fair baby. So this sort of propagation is so wrong. It will defeat the purpose of actually garbh sanskar. Garbh sanskar is the education of the child inside the womb to have a healthy baby. And I think the emphasis should be on the health of the mother and the health of the baby. But
yes.
हाँ, but
go ahead doctor.
हाँ, तो गोरे और काले तो वो उसका नाम और निशान हाँ, that should be taken off completely. It should not be anything about fairness. Only the health of the child and the mother.
कहा कि भगवान कृष्ण हमारे गोरे नहीं थे, भगवान राम हमारे गोरे नहीं थे,
भगवान शंकर हमारे गोरे नहीं थे. Professor Asha, go ahead.
एक तो मिस्टर बंसल, मैं प्रोफेसर हूँ, आप उंगली मत दिखाइए, हम लोगों को उंगली मत दिखाइए. मैं हिंदू हूँ, आप हमें समझाइए नहीं कि हमें क्या आना चाहिए. नहीं, मैं अनाथ आश्रम में काम करती हूँ जहाँ हर तरह के बच्चे आते हैं. कुछ दिन पहले एक 4 दिन का बच्चा एक बच्ची को जमीन पे फेंका. आपके अटॉर्नी जनरल, चुप करिए मिस्टर बंसल, आपके अटॉर्नी जनरल सुप्रीम कोर्ट को कहते हैं कि हमें अपने बदन पे कुछ ये नहीं है, कंट्रोल नहीं है, ये गवर्नमेंट कंट्रोल करेगी. अब तो आप हमारे घर पे भी कंट्रोल करोगे. जाइए जमीन पे, देखिए जब औरत को खाना नहीं मिलता है, आप तो लेक्चर सुनाएंगे कि आपको खाना पड़ेगा.
Okay. So let me just I'm just going to go to every member of the panel. One second. Naveen Chomal, our submission is simply this. I have tremendous respect for those people working tirelessly towards making sure that pregnant women and newborn babies are healthy and they are well and they have access to medical science and food. This happens, for example, in the Anganwadis of our country, where they ensure that these women have access to good nutritious food, they have access to healthcare, they have access to vaccinations. These are important. My only submission from the beginning of this show to the end of this show is simply this. if there is someone in this country who, in the name of any sort of science, ancient or modern, is promising people that your babies can be fairer, that person needs to be stopped immediately.
See,
one very good example that I would like to give is our Bharat Ratna Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. He was born in a very humble background, but still he must be a most intelligent person, and we had to confer the Bharat Ratna upon him, and he has done a great service to the nation, and he was the greatest of the personalities of a nation. So ultimately, please appreciate that it is not as what you are saying, that if the parents are not very intelligent, how can you have baby who are intelligent? So ultimately, what you are saying, that good nutrition should be given to the mother, aiming at a good child. So this Garbha Sanskar scientifically act as a catalyst in that process, okay. And they enhance that, okay. And ensure that child who is born is more healthy, good height, good personality, and the color of skin you are talking, it's a good luster, as Dr. Vijay Kulkarni has very rightly said. It's a good luster of the skin, and there is nothing wrong in having a healthy skin. So okay. Please don't malign a
Dr. Dalwai. Dr. Dalwai, closing statement. Dr. Dalwai, very quickly. Dr. Dalwai.
It's not about any institution. All of us, sab saath mein kaam karenge, phir bhi kam padenge, kyun desh mein itna kaam baki hai.
Exactly.
Aap jo kaam kar rahe hain, अगर उससे जो बच्चा पैदा होने वाला है अगर वो स्वस्थ रहेगा अच्छा रहेगा अगर माँ की सेहत अच्छी रहेगी तो ये सबसे अच्छी काम है अच्छी बात है ये आप भी करना चाहिए हम भी करना चाहिए और सब लोगों ने साथ में करना चाहिए बंसल जी सुनिए एक मिनट बंसल साहब एक मिनट सुनिए तो ये जो आप कर रहे हैं आपके माध्यम से करिए कोई अपने एलोपैथिक से करे कोई आयुर्वेदिक से करे कोई होम्योपैथी से करे कोई किसी से भी करे ये अच्छा काम है एक सिर्फ आपत्ति है कि अगर कहीं पर किसी को अगर कोई गलतफहमी हो सकती है तो ये कलर और ये वर्ण और ये अगर इशू से किसी को आपत्ति है और अगर ये बाय चांस आपके बातों में कहीं आई हो तो हमारा इतना ही आपसे अपील है रिक्वेस्ट है आप भी कह रहे हैं कि भगवान भी सांवले रंग के हैं तो आपको उससे कोई आपत्ति नहीं है तो मेहरबानी करके ये अगर शब्द कहीं आया होगा तो आज से आगे उसको निकालिए हमारी दरखास्त है आपसे और हमें कोई इसमें डिबेट नहीं है दूसरी एक बात है कि गर्भ उतना ही जरूरी है उसके बाद जब बच्चा पैदा right, होता right. है तो उसको देखना भी उतना
very well,
जरूरी
well,
है तो ये चीजें
well
हमें
said.
बच्चों को उनके माताओं को पहुंचानी चाहिए
ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द वुमेन ऑफ दिस कंट्री वी मस्ट रिमेंबर That fair, that dark babies get given up for adoption, like Professor Asha just told us. That darker women get demanded of more dowry. That darker women get told that they cannot find a spouse. We need to work collectively. Every member of this panel needs to work collectively to make sure that every skin color in our country is welcome and accepted as part of this country. That is our only point. Telling any parent that it is possible to change the skin color of your child is setting up expectations that will be detrimental to the child that is born, that will be detrimental to all of us. Because let me point out that none of us are fair. We are all brown. We are all dark. We are all Indian. And that is something we need to be proud of. And I'm proud of it. And I understand that there is this entire thing that we should battle, but we should battle it together. Our only submission, and I say it again, if that someone has promised that you can have a fairer child in some way, that promise needs to be removed. That promise needs to be stopped. That promise needs to be fought. Thanks for watching.